आपके सामने है जूलियस सीजर का एक्ट 5 सीन 1 और अब वीडियो में हम वर्कबुक आंसर्स को पढ़ेंगे। क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट, एंटनी आस्क ऑक्टेवियस टू लीड द बैटल फ्रॉम, आंसर इज द लेफ्ट साइड। एंटनी ने ऑक्टेवियस से कहा कि वो इस लड़ाई को किस साइड से लड़ेगा, लेफ्ट तरफ से। सेकेंड, एंटनी एड्रेसेस ब्रूटस एंड कैसियस एज विलन्स। थर्ड, कैसियस बिलीव इन द फिलोसफी ऑफ एपिक्यूरस। फोर्थ, कमिंग फ्रॉम सार्दिस द आर्मी सो टू माइटी ईगल्स। फिफ्थ, ब्रूटस इज डिफीटेड वॉज नॉट कंटेंटेड टू बी लेड थ्रू द स्ट्रीट एज ही कैप्टिव। क्वेश्चन नंबर वन, पैसेज वन, फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन, व्हाट रीजन डस एंटनी गिव टू ऑक्टेवियस फॉर द एनिमीज अटैकिंग देम फर्स्ट। एंटनी सेज देयर एनिमी अटैक फर्स्ट टू प्रिटेंड दे आर ब्रेव एंड टू मेक एंटनी एंड ऑक्टेवियस थिंक दे हैव करेज। क्वेश्चन सेकेंड, व्हाट न्यूज डस अ मैसेंजर ब्रिंग आफ्टर द एक्सट्रैक्ट। व्हाट डस एंटनी सजेस्ट टू ऑक्टेवियस, हाउ डस ऑक्टेवियस डिसएग्री विद एंटनी, गिव टू इंस्टेंस। आंसर इज द मैसेंजर सेज द एनिमी इज अप्रोच फ्रॉम फॉर बैटल। एंटनी टेल ऑक्टेवियस टू लीड हिज फोर्सेज ऑन द लेफ्ट साइड। ऑक्टेवियस डिसएग्रीज एंड वांट्स टू टेक द राइट साइड इंस्टेड। When Antony asks why Octavius is opposing him, Octavius says he will do as he wishes. Third question, what military strategy was followed? What was Brutus' argument for following this strategy? Answer is, the strategy was to move from the hills and fight on the plains. Brutus argued it was better to face the enemy directly rather than waiting for them to become stronger. Fourth question, how does Antony describe the unethical manner in which the conspirator attacked Caesar? Who does he compare them to? Answer is, Antony says the conspirators attacked Caesar while pretending to be friendly. He compares them to apes, dogs, slaves, and call out Casca for striking Caesar from behind like a coward. Question 5, how does Octavius show better capability and practically compared to Antony as he stand arguing with the conspirators? The answer is, Octavius stays calm and firm during the argument. He makes clear decisions such as leading the right side of the field, showing confident and independent thinking. He gives clear command to his troops, showing he is ready to lead effectively in battle. Second passage, question first. After the extract, Cassius narrates two contradicting sides he saw. What were they? Why does he feel the sides symbolize? Answer is, Cassius saw two mighty eagles perched on their flag and fleeing from soldiers' hand, which he felt was a good sign. However, the eagles were replaced by raven, crow, and kites, which he felt symbolized doom and defeated. Second question, give the meaning of the lines that follow the extract, as we wear sickly prey, their shadow seems a canopy most fatal. This line means that the bird's shadow make the soldier feel like they are weak and dying prey, with the shadows forming a deadly covering over them. Third question, what characteristics of Cassius are seen? How does he appear to have different bent of mind from what he had earlier in the play? Cassius appears superstitious and fearful. Earlier in the play, he was confident and dismissive of omens, following Epicurean philosophy where denied supernatural sign. Fourth question, what philosophy has Cassius followed earlier? Why does he discard the philosophy? Answer is, Cassius follows Epicurean philosophy which denies omens and supernatural sign. He discard it because he now believes the omens he see, the bird, are real and signify their defeat. So he had become more fearful and superstitious. Fifth question, state the reason for Cassius' downfall when Brutus is concerned. Answer is, Cassius' downfall is partially due to Brutus' poor decision, such as moving the army from a strategic position on the hills to the plain. Cassius also suffer from a lack of unity and trust between him and Brutus, and he is increasing superstition weakness his results. Passage 3, question number 1. What has Brutus just said to make Cassius utter these words? Answer is, Brutus has just said that he does not believe in committing suicide out of fear of what might happen. Instead, he prepared to face whatever the future holds with patience. Second, what Roman practice is referring to by Cassius as a result of losing a battle? The answer is, Cassius is referring to a Roman practice by parading defeated leader through the street of Rome in chain as a part of triumphal procession. Third, explain there even a Brutus will go bound to Rome. How do Brutus word so that he is truly honorable? Answer is there that ever Brutus will go bound to Rome means that the Brutus would never allow himself to be taken as a prisoner to Rome. Brutus word so his honor because he is determined to maintain his dignity and would rather die than be paraded as a defeated captive. Fourth question. What was the significance of the Ides of March? What was its effect later in the play? Answer is, the Ides of March was the day Julius Caesar was assassinated by Brutus and Cassius and other conspirators. Its effect later in the play includes the ensuing civil war, the decision among the conspirators, and ultimately leading to their downfall. Last question. Do Brutus and Cassius meet again? If not, why? The answer is no. Brutus and Cassius do not meet again because both of them die in the battle or at Philippi. Cassius commits suicide after mistakenly believes that his friend Titinius has been captured. And Brutus kills himself after realizing that their cause is lost.